Somebody run into our post out there and knocked it off, broke the rail off. Amen. If it was somebody in the church, amen, let us know. If it was you, your liability insurance might take care of it. I don't think it was. Nobody's told me anyway. Amen. So we may have to see if ours will take care of it. Broke our guardrail off our handicap ramp. Amen. Let us know if you know anything about it. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Reading Matthew chapter 6, this is the Lord's Prayer, and this is a part of the Sermon on the Mount. But when ye pray, use not vain repetitions as the heathen do, for they think that they shall be heard for their much speaking. Be not ye therefore like unto them, for your Father knoweth what things ye have need of before ye ask him. After this manner therefore pray ye, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Then he enlarges on one part of that prayer. For if ye forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if ye forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. Everybody that believes it, say amen. Going back to the 10th verse. Thy kingdom come. I'd like to preach tonight for a few moments. It'll not take long. Return to kingdom come. America has witnessed a great election this week. One of the biggest voter turnouts in some time, particularly for Ohio and this part of Ohio. Amen. And we have heard all of the campaigning and all the pros and cons. Amen. But I'll tell you one thing the church will find out as it becomes more and more involved in politics, quote, end quote. Amen. That we're going to have to find out that the church once lived in kingdom come. Amen. It seems in time she moved away and no longer prayed, thy kingdom come. Often like Naomi of old, she returned to Bethlehem with a plaintive wail. I went out full and came back empty. Call me Mara, not Naomi, for the Lord the Almighty hath dealt bitterly with me. Amen. The Christian coalition fell short of its goal. A few years ago, Pat Robertson said he felt led to run for president. Amen. You see, Pat no longer preaches the rapture of the church as we one time preached it. Amen. He preaches now that they were just going to get better and better, and Christians are going to unite together. And because they unite together, they're going to take over the political arena. And we're going to start the millennium right here on the earth. Did you know that's not new? That's old. Amen. They tried it over 1,000 years ago. Amen. They preached amillennialism, amen, since 300 A.D. Amen. That the world's going to get better and better. The Christians are going to become more involved, and they're going to take over politics. There's just one thing wrong with that. They moved out of kingdom come and said, kingdom's already here. We're just going to take the kingdom by force. Amen. They moved out of kingdom come into kingdom now. Amen. Oh, yes. Praise God. I think, you know, the reason that God, amen, bids us watch for the king for 2,000 years was that he wanted the church in every generation to look for kingdom come. Every generation, including Paul, including John.
I mean, that's it. Everything else is incidental to that. Why? We're trying to get out of here. We're trying to get out of here, just like that man Sister Carolyn's telling about. I know him. Yeah, he got tired of that prison. He is ready to get out. Those guys in there resented it because he is going to get out, and they's having to stay, and they done everything in the world to cause him to lose his temper and get in a fight and draw more time. And he took it. Why? Because he was accounting the days and accounting the hours till he could walk out the main gate. Hallelujah. We ought to be counting the days and counting the hours because we're so close to walking out of here. Thank the Lord. Say goodbye, old world. I'm through with you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I'll have to put up with
this world is in control of things for the most part. Amen. And you go out and try to transform this world, I'll tell you what's going to happen to all these preachers that feel like they can change things. Amen. In the political arena, becoming more involved, they're going to wind up casting their pearls before swine, and the swine are going to turn again and trample their pearls and rend them. Amen. Praise God. Ah, yes. And only after repeated failures. Oh, I don't know how many failures we're going to have. I don't know how many dominions are going to have to crumble. I don't know how many dynasties and tyrannies are going to have to fall. Amen. I don't know how many of the utopian dreams of men and kings and rulers and organizers and the parties, amen, are going to have to explode before they realize that we need to move back into thy kingdom come. Amen. I can't remember the author. Maybe it was Fox that wrote the same one that wrote The Trail of the Lonesome Pine. Maybe it was Fox also that wrote Living in Kingdom Come. I read the book, amen, The Little Shepherd of Kingdom Come, instead of Living in Kingdom Come. The Little Shepherd of Kingdom Come. Hallelujah. And then Vance Havner said Living. He preached his message and wrote it down for preachers to preach after him. Living in kingdom come. Yes. Amen. Don't you think it's about time the church moved back into thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Let's all go back to kingdom come. Let's all pray thy kingdom come. Let's all pray thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. What's the price of living? Amen. In kingdom come. Hallelujah. You got to forget about self. You got to forget about your own utopian dreams. Amen. You can't pour your feet in the concrete of this world. You got to wear this world like a loose garment, ready to shed it in a moment's time. Amen. You got to live in a readiness to leave here. The old song says, I don't want to get adjusted to this world. To this world. Amen. I got a home that's so much better. I'm going to go there sooner or later. I don't want to get adjusted to this world. Amen. What's the price of living in kingdom come and praying for the Lord to come? Could it be that the church will have to get in enough trouble, see enough failure, have enough reverses, enough trials and tribulations, that she'll have to pray, Lord, come quickly, thy kingdom come?
Yes.
Amen. John had been exiled on Patmos. They'd tried to boil him in a pot of boiling oil, tradition says, and he was too tough to fry. So they exiled him on that lonely isle of Patmos. It was there on that lonely island, perhaps somewhere in a lonely cave, amen, that the beloved sainted Apostle John got the book of Revelation.
Yes.
John was in trouble when he got the book of Revelation. He was a prisoner in exile when he got the book of Revelation. It wasn't hard to say when Jesus said, "Behold, I come quickly," for John to chime in the last verse and say, "Even so, come quickly, Lord Jesus." Amen. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. The price of living in kingdom come is you got to stay ready. How do you stay ready? You got to pray the Lord's Prayer in depth. Amen. You pray, "Give us this day our daily bread." And every day you give God all you got. Every day you give God 100%. You don't make any plans that leave God out. You don't make any plans that leave His work out. You don't make any plans that leave His worship out. If you live in kingdom come, there's a price to pay. You don't do it like you want to anymore. You do it like God wants to. After all, if we're living and looking for the kingdom to come, amen, how would you want to live and be found looking if it comes tonight? Amen. Have I been faithful to the service He has given? Amen. The harvest of thy fields have we done? Amen. Have we put God first? Have we obeyed that good advice of Jesus that said, "Seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness"? Every day we seek Him first. Every day we put Him first. Every day we pray, "Thy will be done. Thy kingdom come." Amen. We wind up our prayer, "For Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever." Amen. Preacher came along and said he had a new revelation, told Brother Fred Hatfield. Amen. Got a new revelation. The Lord's already come and the millennium's already started. Amen. Brother Fred Hatfield said, "Every day I'm looking for the King." Praise God. And praying, "Thy kingdom come." Be honest. Be honest. Amen. What plans would you make if His kingdom was coming tomorrow? If His kingdom was coming this week? If His kingdom was coming next week? Amen. And He may call even before that. Brother Burns stood up tonight and requested prayer for a family that a man and his wife went to bed with nothing wrong with it. She went in and made the coffee and went to look for him and found him dead. A 35-year-old man, amen, found dead. Time's up. The call went forth, and he answered the call. Hallelujah. What is the price of staying ready for the King? Amen. He said, "Pray, Father, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us." Amen. For if we forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your heavenly Father forgive you of your trespasses. You see, the Christians today are not supposed to be an element of division and grudging and jealousy and strife. The Christian today is supposed to be an instrument of peace. Of them that make peace. Hallelujah. This wisdom from above, James said, is peaceable. Easy to be entreated. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. We pray, Father, forgive our debts as we forgive our debtors. Forgive our trespasses as we forgive those who trespassed against us. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who have sinned against us. It's a price of getting inside the gates of kingdom come. Because you see, you're not ready to face the judge when you put yourself on the judgment seat on this side. You're not ready to face the judge, for if you've not forgiven here, neither will he forgive you there. Amen. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. He said, give us this day our daily bread. Amen. The song says, one day at a time, sweet Jesus, is all I'm asking for you. Amen. Oh, yes, praise God. We look too far ahead. We plan too far ahead sometimes. Oh, it's all right to plan, but make them tentative. James tells us how to plan. We say we're going to go to such and such a city and there live and work and get gain. He said, you ought to say, if the Lord will.
Yes. Right. Yes.
The kingdom may come. No matter where we live. We need to know that we're ready for the kingdom to come. Amen. We need to be ready to give and forgive. Praise God. Amen. Jesus said in the 25th chapter of Matthew, amen, concerning those that you saw me sick and you visited me. You saw me in prison and you visited me. You saw me naked and you clothed me. You saw me hungry and you fed me. Yet they will say, Lord, when saw we naked and sick and afflicted or in prison? Amen. And he says, inasmuch as you did it unto the least of these, my brethren, you did it unto me. And they were ready for the king when he came.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
But to another group he said, I was sick and in prison and you visited me not. I was naked and you didn't clothe me. I was hungry and you didn't feed me. And they said, Lord, if we'd have known that you were hungry, we'd have fed you. If we'd have known that you were naked, we'd have clothed you. If we'd have known it was you. And I preached that message years ago. Lord, I didn't know it was you. But that's the way he knocks. Amen. He said, inasmuch as you did it not unto the least of these my brethren, ye did it not unto me. And then he said something strange about those stingy, parsimonious. Amen. Parsimonious is just like saying stingy gut in Arkansas. Selfish. Amen. In Ohio. Amen. Yeah, what did he say to those selfish, stingy people? Amen. Those parsimonious people that thought they couldn't afford, amen, to give.
Yes.
He said, depart from me into everlasting fire. Amen. And class them with the workers of iniquity. It's in that same book of Matthew. You think I should go over there and read it? Amen. Amen. Matthew 25. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Then he shall answer them, saying, verse 45, verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye did it not to one of the least of these, ye did it not to me. And these shall go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into life eternal.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. He shall say unto them on the left hand, depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. Jesus said that. For I was a hungered and you gave me no meat. I was thirsty and you gave me no drink. I was a stranger and you took me not in. Naked and you clothed me not. Sick and in prison and you visited me not. Amen. The price of living in kingdom come is to give and forgive. Amen. Last of all, amen, let's commit the kingdom back to God. Huh? Amen. Quit trying to play God. Quit capitalizing on sensational gimmickry in the area of eschatology, amen, to sell books and get a following and look sharp. Amen. Sensationalism. No, we still don't know when Jesus is coming. He didn't come, amen, in 88, so therefore 88 reasons why he should come in 88 went in the wastebasket. Amen. He didn't come in September 1996, as some said he was coming, so therefore, amen, a whole bunch more stuff goes in the wastebasket. It shook up a few. It stirred up a few. Raised a few eyebrows for a while. Stirred a sensation for a while. Amen. Even some, quote, Pentecostals, end quote, amen, get carried away with that stuff. Amen. Oh, glory to God. Hey, let's turn God's business back to God. And let's work while it's day. Let's do our best while we wait. Amen. Oh, what are we going to have to go through? How many failures are we going to have to fail? How many dreams are we going to have to see far by the wayside before we turn the kingdom back to God and say, God, that's your business. It's my business to serve you and do my best till I die. He said, blessed are those servants whom the Lord shall find so doing. Faithful. Hallelujah. Ready. Prepared. Looking for Him. And there's still a crown laid up for Paul. And not for Paul only, but for all those that love His appearing. It wouldn't be hard to look for the King if you was in the kind of trouble Paul was in. Spent most of his ministry in jail and wrote most of his great writings, amen, from prison. Amen. A day and a night in the deep, 5 times beaten with rods, beaten with an inch of his life. There was whelps and scars all over his body. There was gashes in his head where he was stoned at Lystra. Amen. And God raised him from the dead after taking him on a tour of that city, paradise, to see unspeakable things, impossible to tell, mundane earthlings. Praise God. Had such revelations that was given to him a thorn in the flesh. It wasn't hard for Paul to pray, thy kingdom come. Amen. Someday we'll suffer enough pain. Someday we'll suffer enough agony. Someday we'll see enough trouble. Someday we'll see enough tears. Someday our hearts will be broken enough. And we'll give the kingdom back to God and say, Lord, I give up. I can't do it. I've tried to mete out my own future. I've tried to look after my own self. Amen. Oftentimes the preacher's the first one that has to learn, because he has to teach others. And everything in life, we're a failure unless we put God first. We need to understand our first job, amen, first and foremost, is to preach the gospel. We're God's men and men. We've got to live to drop everything and go at the drop of the hat, and sometimes drop it ourselves. And sometimes that makes it hard on our wives and on our children, unless they get armed in their mind to do the same thing, to go at God's beck and call. You mean, Philip, you're going to leave that good revival at Samaria and all those crying sheep and all those young converts? Well, I went and got Peter and John, amen, and they're down there, hallelujah. But God speaks to Philip to go down to the desert, amen, toward Gaza. There he found one Ethiopian eunuch, one black man on his way back home. And God said, join yourself to the church. The old preacher that preached against joining churches and joining denominations said that's the only place in the Bible that God ever told anybody to join anything. Amen. He told Philip to join himself, amen, to the chariot. Woo, glory to God. If we're not careful, we'll get a kingdom attitude in the things that we've joined. If we're not careful, we'll get a kingdom ambition in the things that have a headquarters in this world. Hey, our headquarters is not in this world. Our headquarters is the New Jerusalem. Amen. And Jesus rules from heaven. And don't you think it's time we gave the kingdom back to God? You give the kingdom back to God and live in kingdom come. You'll not let anything stand between you and the service of the Lord. You'll not let having fun and cheap pleasure in this world stand between you and serving God. Amen. God will come first. Praise God. And you'll be able to sing with a little more gusto. I ain't gonna lay my armor down. I ain't gonna lay my armor down. I ain't gonna lay my armor down. Till he comes. Hallelujah. It's a wonderful thing to live in kingdom come. Yeah. Naomi moved out. They went down to Moab. Moab is the world. Bethlehem is the county seat of the kingdom. Amen. That's where the king's coming from. That's where David's coming out of. Hallelujah. Amen. If you move out one time too many, you're going to miss the king. But Naomi said, I'm going home. Even if I come home empty, I'm going back full-fledged to Bethlehem. And when grandma went home, she brought a Gentile daughter-in-law with her. And her Gentile daughter-in-law, amen, went together at the gleaning. Amen. And Boaz fell in love with her at first sight. Paid the redemption price, praise God. Amen. And it wasn't too long till Naomi was rocking Obed. Amen. In her arms. Obed, praise God, became the father of Jesse. And Jesse became the father of David. Hey, what if Ruth hadn't went back? What if Naomi hadn't went back? She'd have missed the king and the kingdom. Stand with me tonight. You don't want to miss it. It may happen tomorrow, but if it don't, let's stay inside the security of the city walls of thy kingdom come. And put God first in our lives. Amen. As they sing, we invite you to the altar of prayer. Father in heaven, take this service, Lord, and make it count for God. Take this message, Lord, and make it count for God. Oh, Lord, take our words. Render them profound on the wings of the Spirit as they speak to the heart and souls of men. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Brother Collins, if I listen to you, I'll be so heavily minded, I'll be no earthly good. That's all right. God ain't got too many of them. He needs a few of them. Amen. Try it. You might like it. Praise God. Come on tonight. As they sing, we invite you to
my
kingdom come.
Just on credit. There's no guarantee of life.